Get ready to match the stars from Vegas, Bart Braverman, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from the Young and the Restless, Erica Hope, Artie Johnson, and Fanny Fly, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Wilber.
All right, I thank you one and all for joining us. You're going to be happy you came because the loonies are out. Yes, I have my long microphone back, and I'm so happy about it.
Get a caught in your nose.
Did the thief return it, or did they get you a new one?
I think this is a brand new one. Look, this is a brand new microphone.
That's because you're old.
Be careful how you use it. Get caught in your nostril, it'll go right up in your eye. Into your
Now, we will all sing one chorus of "O Come All Ye Faithful." Cut. That's enough. Let's say hello to our two players here, Vicky Durrett and Grace Burkutt. All right, Charles. Our current champ is Vicky with $1,200. And Grace is challenging her. We're in the middle of round one, and she did fairly well with her first round question, matching two of our stars. And we'll continue with your question in a moment. First, this for you. Here we go, and now this is it. Round one, the other question. What?
Nothing.
You're ready. Here we go. Skinny Minnie is so skinny.
How skinny is she?
You're okay. Her legs are like toothpicks, so instead of shoes, she wears blanks. Skinny Minnie is so skinny, her legs are like toothpicks, instead of shoes, she wears blanks, okay?
Would you repeat the question?
Skinny Minnie is so skinny, her legs are like toothpicks.
I like it.
So instead of shoes, she wears blanks.
I don't get it.
Remember, it's a round one question. Anything, because you can stray far afield. Anything that pops into your little head is perfectly all right. Laugh again.
Don't do this.
Do the Gettysburg Address for us.
I don't know. Wait. Our fathers? No.
No. All right, Vicky. Skinny Minnie is so skinny, her legs are like toothpicks. So instead of shoes, she wears blanks.
Olives.
Olives. I don't know what else.
Oh, yeah.
I associate toothpicks with olives, don't you?
Like a woman who drinks.
Olives.
Olives, okay. Now, I know you don't drink. But olives, you see, are used in martinis.
No, it's
and they have toothpicks.
Yes, I know, but there are other things, and they're called I Love Manhattan Maraschino Cherries.
Maraschino, she wears Maraschino Cherries.
It's the same.
Okay, that's right. No, it's the same thing as, same idea. Okay, all right.
Okay. What?
She wears, this is not my answer, but she has a lovely two-piece, I'll be all right, the dental work, a lovely two-piece green suit, which she wears with her olive.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, ensemble. 2-2 is the score now. Erica Hope, Skinny Minnie is so skinny, her legs are like toothpicks, so instead of shoes, she wears...
Before you boo me, I love my answer. Teeth.
On the end of a toothpick. Yeah.
You understand.
Yeah.
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 Okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
All right.
She's younger than I am, and they didn't show much respect for her. What the hell are they going to do for me? Teeth.
Listen, you dye your hair blonde. And shave your chest, and you'll be all right. Now we come to Fanny Flagg.
Yes, I happen to have a lot of personal friends in the audience who I know would be happy.
I think it's brilliant.
All right, so the score remains at 2-2. We go to round two now, and Grace, you may have A or B.
B for Burkett.
B for Burkett. Here it is. On the airplane, Herb said, I think the pilot used to be a cab driver. As we were taxiing on the runway, he blanked at the other planes.
I think the pilot used to be a cab driver.
As we were taxiing on the runway, he blanked at the other planes. Okay? All right. Grace. On the airplane, Herb said, I think the pilot used to be a cab driver. As we were taxiing on the runway, he blanked at the other planes.
Oh, my gosh. I'd love to say baloney, but that can't be the answer.
Cab driver. As he was driving on the runway with his airplane, he blanked at the other planes.
He flagged the other plane.
Well, I guess she drew a blank. She says flagged. But we were trying to get him to do, you know, what cab drivers do to each other.
I'm really so sorry. You know, in New York, you have to take voice lessons so that you can yell.
He yelled at the other planes, you know. Or honked at them or did whatever.
And curse.
Curse. Right.
You never lived in New York, right? See? That's okay. Cursed.
All right. Yeah, maybe we should have said New York cab driver,
yes,
and that might have been
so.
A little clue to her. Okay, Erica, what do you say?
He cursed.
Cursed. Okay. So there we are at the middle of round two, and the score remains tied 2-2, and we'll see what happens right after we see about this. Hello there.
Yes.
Vicky, are you ready? All right.
Goodness.
All you need is one to win. Ralph said, I just invented the world's strongest drink. It's called the Autumn Leaves Cocktail. After you have just one, you blank. It's the world's strongest drink called the Autumn Leaves Cocktail. One, two, three, four. Everybody ready? Put one in that slot there. Ralph said, I just invented the world's strongest drink. It's called the Autumn Leaves Cocktail. After you have just one, you blank.
You fall.
Okay. All right, Brett, what do you say?
I say July, August, September, October, fall.
Fall it is, and that wins the game. What the rest of you have? Okay. Good luck to you with your poetry endeavors. And we'll send some gifts your way for Match Game 78. Grace Burkett, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Vicky's up here for the third time. Going to have another go at the big money here. And are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Chamberlain. Remember how it goes, $500 for matching the most popular, and the second most popular gets you $250, and then the third most popular response, if you team up with that one, you get $100. And six of our celebrated people will give you some assistance.
Artie?
I'd say Wilt Chamberlain.
There's one.
And Bart?
Bart?
You heard from the governor yet?
Yeah.
To be on, Wilt Chamberlain, Richard Chamberlain.
All right, the actor Richard Chamberlain.
Erica.
Erica, have you got one?
Neville
Chamberlain.
Who?
Former Neville Chamberlain, former Prime Minister.
Oh, how soon
the
they forget.
Beginning
you
of
see, you
World
get sophisticated
War II.
And know what you're talking about.
That's right.
W-I-I.
Right. Okay, so you have Neville Chamberlain, the man who carried the umbrella. And Richard Chamberlain, the actor, and Wilt Chamberlain, he's the, you know, what have you got there?
Wilt Chamberlain.
You want Wilt Chamberlain? Oh, Wilt Chamberlain. Okay, let's see where he is, if he is up there at all. May we see the $100 number? Neville Chamberlain is there. Very good. Erica's answer. Now the $250 response. Richard, yeah, running true to form. There's Bart's answer. Attaboy. All right. I would bet anything that it's going to be there, but we got to find out by revealing it now.
Yeah!
Wow! Well, you pick up another $500, and you got a total of $1,800 right now. But more important than that, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. However, you could double it and play for $10,000 instead of $5,000. Give it a spin, and good luck to you. You've done it before. Let's see if you can do it again. If it stops to the blue light arm, that means it's automatically a double. Let's get it. Oh, just went off the blue light there. $5,000 with Charles Nelson Reilly. Good luck to you, and this is it. Blank stamp. STAMP. Blank stamp. Blank stamp. Okay, Chuck is finished. If you give us the answer that he's got written on that card, you get $5,000. What do you say to that? Blank stamp.
Postage stamp.
Yeah, that's what I think. I hope Charles says it. If Charles says it, you get $5,000.
I was going to put postage stamp.
You have $6,800. Congratulations to you. Your mother's very happy, I see. Okay, if you're ready, we'll bring on another player. Here comes Mike Johnson. Hello, Mike. Okay, as soon as it stops, there you go. Vicky is very happy, Lady Mike. She's got $6,800 all together. And we'd like to find out a little bit about you before we start the competition. We're a friendly bunch here, so tell us anything you want about yourself.
Well, I was born and raised in a small town in a fine state of Nebraska.
Yeah.
Graduated the University of Nebraska at Lincoln, and I'm currently working for a major oil company. And I like racquetball and snow skiing.
Okay, nice to have you with us. Many famous people have come from Nebraska, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
And many in our business, many famous theatrical people have come from Nebraska. Good luck to you, Mike. You, what?
Johnny Carson. No.
Fred and Adele Astaire.
Yes, go ahead. Oh, keep going. Tell them all. Floyd Nipney.
Henry Fonda.
Lloyd Stalmisch.
They're all Nebraska
Rosetta
people.
Rosetta Kornweiler.
You said name two, I've named
and
three.
And that effervescent girl, Seth Fraglethorpe.
Where are you going?
We're going
Nebraska.
You're going to Nebraska.
We're exhausted. Maybe I'll have to go home and go to bed now.
All right, Mike, do you ever have A or a B?
I'll take B, please.
B for Nebraska. Bill said, this new T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with a sporting goods store on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw. T-shirt.
I get it.
Okay. You ready, Mike?
Ready.
They're not. Okay, now. Bill said this new T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with a sporting goods store in her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
I could see it in Bart's eyes. He's thinking basketball.
Basketball. Yeah, the biggest basketballs I ever saw.
They look like pucks to me.
It's too bad you can't use really dirty words here. I was just going from what you said, racquetballs.
Racquetballs. Okay, what do you say?
Well, you know me, hon. No fanny flag. I said tennis balls.
Tennis balls. That's about a minus A cup.
Oh, I was gonna put basketball.
Oh, and you did. Good for you. That's one for him. Got a little basketball for old Mike Johnson over there.
Yes, you have.
That's nice. Ryan, what
have
you
never seen anyone with basketballs?
Huh? I have.
I said numerals.
Numerals.
And good for you that you did. You were right.
Okay. Now you, Fanny.
As what usual in life, as in this game, I go too far. Pontoons.
Pontoons, eh? Hmm. So there you are, Mike. Two, not bad for a first round question. You stand by for yours. Now this for you, America. What do you say, John? All right, Viv, you ready? This is your first round question. Here we go. Did you hear about the farmer's daughter?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I'll tell you. She loved leather clothing so much.
Right into it.
Once she went into the barn to try on a blank. She went into the barn to try on a blank.
I have no doubt she did.
Oh. Loved leather clothing.
Okay. It's an easy one.
Okay. Here we go. The farmer's daughter. She loved leather clothing so much, once she went into the barn to try on a blank.
I hope saddles are made of leather.
Saddle? Yeah, they're made of leather.
Okay.
She went into the barn to try on a saddle.
A saddle?
Yeah.
And I thought I was into discipline and bondage.
Yes.
But harness.
Harness.
That's kind of a saddle.
Well, it's part of it. No, I guess it's not.
You want to be really picky. It's not a saddle.
Yeah, I'm picky. It's not a saddle. I'm sorry about that. Show us your saddle.
I suppose bull wouldn't work, right?
No.
I said harness, too, because I figured you sit on. You're always sitting on a saddle.
Yes. I don't know. The harness is different from a saddle, yes.
Well, an appearance at the state fair was coming up. Calf.
Tried on a calf. Interesting. Okay. She went into the barn to try on a...
I thought this was cute. Harness.
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 Yeah, it's cute.
See, I got an applaud.
One applaud.
I just drew a bath.
You drew a bathtub? Yes. Freehand?
No, I just drew a bath.
Oh, you drew a bath.
Yes.
Really bad, huh?
Yes. Well, as an old farm boy, I thought I'd try anything.
A bull. She went in the barn to try on a bull. What did you say to that?
I say, back in the saddle again.
I could do another chorus. Back in the saddle again. 2-1 the score at the end of round one. Round two coming up later. Now this for you. Now, the next time we get together, I want you to see who will be on the show, and then we'll talk, okay?
Bowser! Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Nancy Lane, Don Sutton, and Betty White.
You were all splendid.
Fabulous, thank you.
What happened to Artie?
He shorted himself.
He just leaned back in his chair. That's
Artie, I knew you were short, but that's ridiculous.
You said no more short
jokes. Oh, no more short jokes.
I don't mind short jokes, because tall people aren't going to be around when the revolution comes.
Don't forget to watch for Artie in his movie. It's called...
Love at First Bite.
Love at First Bite, yes. And The Young and Restless. Are you young or restless?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's a little of both. And don't forget Bart Braverman in Vegas.
Yay!
And you?
Brett, old and nervous.
Old and nervous. versus...
Don't forget to get your eyes ready, because March 2nd to March 10th is Save Your Vision Week, and I'm the honorary chairman.
Yes.
So naturally.
I'll bring my eyes.
All right, you join us next time for Mets Game 78. I'm G. Raver. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Mets Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast. I'm gonna go get some more.